Good evening, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Chasing Rabbits. My name is Scott Brown, and you found my vlog dedicated to helping you become the leader you always wished that you had worked for. So indulge me for a minute tonight. We're going to take a little bit of a history lesson down a path that I tend to go, which is useless knowledge, but knowledge that does have a meaning and there's some pertinence to the story here. So indulge me for a moment. Back when I graduated from college in December of 91, there was a guy who came out of the University of Southern California as a basketball player. His name was Harold Miner. He was a shooting guard, was a fantastic athlete, was bald, great dunker, was a highlight reel ready to happen, just an all-around interesting kind of character coming out. And he got dubbed because when he played, he had his tongue hanging out, wagging a little bit like Michael Jordan did, so he got dubbed Baby Jordan. And a lot of it was because he did things that were reminiscent of what Jordan did. There were the dunks from the foul line. There was the baseline up and under moves. He was the epitome of the athletic shooting guard that everyone wanted to watch because you never knew what he was going to do next. And somebody asked him one day, I remember reading this interview, and somebody asked him, what does it feel like being referred to as Baby Jordan? Meaning, what does it feel like to be compared to the great Michael Jordan? He played the same position. What does that feel like? And I remember his response. It was so vividly. I remember he said, I hate it. I do not want to be the next Michael Jordan. I want to be the first Harold Miner. Wow. And it was a 22-year-old kid just graduating from college, that was really impactful to me because I never thought of someone being compared to somebody great, not wanting that comparison, but wanting to make your own mark, do your own thing, leave your own legacy behind, not to always be remembered in the shadow of somebody else, but to remember being who you were as an individual, who you were as a leader, who you were as a contributor to society. Now, clearly, most of you don't know who Harold Miner is, but you probably do know who Michael Jordan is. Miner's career didn't pan out nearly as well as what Jordan's did. Turns out he couldn't shoot. Jordan could shoot. Miner could not. So, a little bit of a different career path, but he was really adamant that he never wanted to be known as Baby Jordan. He just always wanted to be known as Harold Miner, the first Harold Miner. So, my question to you is, as you are developing your leadership presence, as you're developing your leadership style, finding your leadership voice, who are those folks that you are emulating? Now, I say emulating and not copying because I don't want you to think about becoming the next version of whomever it is that influences and inspires you, but emulating them in terms of what do they do that resonates with you on such a grand scale that it draws you to action. And maybe you don't do those exact same things, but you can do things that are similar in a way that you emulate their behaviors, you emulate their performances. As an emerging leader, I'm sure there are individuals out there with whom you listen to whose message resonates with you greatly, and you want to emulate that speaking style. You want to emulate the messaging that they have. There's probably also folks out there with whom you do not resonate or that do not resonate with you. Those are individuals that you do not want to necessarily emulate. Some of them are great leaders in their own right. Some of them are not, but some of them just do things in a way that's different from you, that you know that you're never going to be able to bring to life because it's not your personality, it's not your style, it's not your belief system, your value system. It just doesn't match. You don't emulate those folks, but you do emulate the ones whose style, whose messaging, whose voice resonates with you. And I don't know if you've ever thought of who those individuals are that really resonate with you, who the leaders are in your life that really resonate with you, the ones that you want to emulate their delivery, their behaviors. You want to take the best of what they have and turn it and twist it into whom you are so that you can become a better version, a better leader, a better manager, a better individual because you've known that person, you've been able to emulate some of the things they've done. I actually had a number of really good managers and leaders when I first started out, and some of them are individuals that over the course of my career I wanted to try to emulate. Never wanted to copy them, but I always wanted to emulate them. There's also some that I wanted to avoid like the plague, because who they were was exactly who I did not want to be. Those are the ones that I purposely paid attention to what they did to make sure that I understood exactly how they behaved, how they acted, what they said. And they're the folks that I wanted to make sure that I avoided, that I didn't become. But there are also those that I really wanted to emulate, to capture the essence of the best of them. As you are starting out on your leadership journey, or even if you're in the middle of a leadership journey, think about whom those individuals are that meant the most to you, whose messages still resonate within your mind years later, whose voice you hear when you're talking to someone and you can hear somebody else in the back of your mind and you know that they've made an impact upon you. That will also give you an idea of whom it is you should go out and research more, that you should watch more videos, you should watch more YouTube clips, you should watch more TED Talks by those individuals. You may also, if there's still somebody that you know, spend some time with them, pick up the phone and offer to take them to lunch at some point. At a social distance outside in the spring when it's warm, or if you live in Florida, right now, outside. But connect with them. Pick their minds. Let them know how much they meant to you, and maybe they can help you in whatever journey you are on and help you get to that next step, whatever that might be. So think about those folks that you emulate, but as you do, always remember, you never are in this to become the next version of somebody else. You're always in this to become a better version of yourself. Don't be the next Michael Jordan. Be the first Harold Miner. Don't be the first whomever. I wanted to be the first Scott Brown. So with that being said, I wish you all a wonderful evening tonight, and I give you the homework of going out and finding and doing some research with those messages that resonate with you and the individuals with whom you want to emulate within your journey. Have a wonderful night tonight. I wish you well, and I will see you tomorrow. Toast on, everyone. Be well.